Good morning. Today is Tuesday, October 3rd. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yahweh, you search me and know me. Sometimes we feel as though nobody really knows us or even cares to know us. But God always does, even when we fool ourselves into believing that God doesn't. God still does. All through this day, consider that God is walking right beside you. Do you see things differently? All-knowing God, thank you for caring enough about me to know me deep in my heart. Help me to remember that even when I feel discouraged or misunderstood, you know and care how I feel. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Blessed Brother James Miller, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Shamrocks. I'm Zach Hartwig.
And I'm Eli Hernandez.
And this is your Shamrock Morning News.
These are the announcements for October 3rd. Open swim. Take advantage of the pool at St. Pat's. Get in shape for the up-and-coming swim season with open swims. There are a number of times and days to get in the pool from now until the season starts in November. See Mrs. Sabella across from the dean's office for details.
LaSallian Youth, Chipotle fundraiser. Do you like Chipotle? LaSallian Youth is sponsoring a fundraiser on Tuesday, October 3rd between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. at the Norridge location, 4235 North Harlem Avenue. When you make a purchase on this day, 33% of sales get donated to a good cause.
Book discussion. An informational meeting for a book discussion group will be held on Wednesday, October 4th at 8:15 in the library. Come find out what book all the talk is about. If you can't attend, please see Mrs. Sullivan in the library for more details.
Yearbook photos. Retakes. Yearbook photo retakes will be on Tuesday, October 3rd. School ID/yearbook photo retakes, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. in the atrium.
This week, with the weather staying in the 80s this week, khaki shorts will be allowed through Friday. The typical dress code will be in effect this week. Please remember to shave, tuck in your shirt, remove earrings, wear appropriate shoes, and have your ID.
Hello, everyone. Our next all-school mass is coming up, and so just wanted to do a refresher on how to receive Holy Communion. If you are not receiving Holy Communion, you are welcome to stay in your pew. You do not have to come up, but if you would like to come up in procession, you're more than welcome to. We ask that you put your arms across your chest like I'm doing now, so that you can either receive a blessing from the minister or a blessing from the priest. If you are going to be receiving communion, what you should never do is take the Eucharist out of the minister's hand. What you're receiving is a gift, and gifts are not meant to be taken. They are meant to be received. The proper response when receiving Holy Communion is amen. After the minister says, the body of Christ. You say amen after we say, the body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
And you receive our Lord as the great gift that he is. You do not say thank you or just stare at us awkwardly.
The body of Christ.
Thank you.
And so if you receive in your hand, we want you to actually make a throne out of your hand. So your dominant hand that you write with should be on the bottom, your other hand on top. The goal is to not drop Jesus. Remember, it's the fullness of God in that little piece of what looks like bread and tastes like bread is the fullness of divinity. We do not want Jesus to end up on the floor or in your pocket or somewhere else in church. You are to receive him on your hand, and immediately after you receive our Lord, you put Jesus directly in your mouth as you consume our Lord's full body, blood, soul, and divinity. If you're receiving on the tongue, if you're standing, we want you to put your head back and stick out your tongue far enough for the minister to place our Lord on your tongue. If you're kneeling, the same, put your head back a bit and stick your tongue out all the way so that the minister can safely place our Lord on your tongue for you to consume him. I hope this has been helpful to you. Thank you for your attention, and I hope this helps all of us worship God together as a Shamrock family. God bless you all. We'll see you at Mass.
Joseph.
So, who are you wearing and why are you picking me?
I'm wearing Javier Baez because I'm a Cubs fan.
Why are you picking me?
This is my school jersey, but this is my brother's jersey because I couldn't find it.
Awesome, thanks. Why did you pick your jersey?
I'm wearing myself. This is my grade school 8th grade basketball jersey. Great memory for me. Great season with my boys, so that's why I'm wearing this jersey.
Awesome, thanks.
All right, who are we here with?
Josh.
And who's this player and why did you pick him?
I picked for today Ryan Burch, the best QB1 safety and wide receiver on the team.
All right, I'm here with Mr. Burns today. So who's on your jersey and why did you pick him?
That's Sir Walter Payton, number 34, the best running back ever in the NFL. Unfortunately, he died of liver disease in his mid-40s. Actually, the reason why I picked this shirt is it's a size 58, besides Walter Payton on it. It's a size 58. And my 52, which was the number 3 from Notre Dame, Ron Paulus, doesn't fit me anymore.
All right, guys, we're here with Miss Robinson. Who's this player and why did you pick him?
This is Quentin Nelson, and I chose him because I'm a massive Colts fan.
All right, sweet. Thank you. What's up, guys? We're here with Mr. Kemp. Who's this player on the jersey?
This player is myself.
Why did you pick this jersey?
I picked this jersey because the Colts are doing pretty well this year. They're starting out 2-1, and I like repping my home team.